So we have a recap of the Steve Blackman Trish Stratus kendo stick joke for SmackDown. Jim Ross is explaining what happened and says, and this is a quote, and I will try to mimic his delivery as best I can. Get a load of this hilarious misunderstanding. You've never heard a more snarky, sarcastic Jim Ross. It was awesome. All right. So the match is Steve Blackman and Trish Stratus versus Perry Saturn and Terry.
God damn. So these fans did not care one bit about these men.
No.
Deathly, crypt-like silence when they're in the ring. The fans chant, "We want puppies." All they want to see is these two women in there together. If you're wondering who looked more naked, because that was the goal here, right, it was undoubtedly Terry.
For sure.
Sure.
Who wore a very, 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 very small skin-colored outfit. I mean, she may as well have just been nude. She probably would have shown less. And Trish is out there, and she wore very little, but at least it was like, you know,
she was wearing clothes.
Opposite her
this.
Skin tone.
Yes.
And they get in there, and they do their spots, and it's absolutely beyond horrific. It's beyond horrible. I know people make fun of the AEW women, but dude,
this is much worse.
Oh my God.
A thousand times worse.
But the fans are going crazy for it. And finally the men tag back in, and it's deathly silence again. You gotta remember that there were actually women in the crowd, but even the women didn't want to see the men wrestle. Yeah. No one on the planet did.
No. So this match is very famous, as I'm sure most people listening are well aware of why, but the match begins, I know where it's going, and I'm waiting, and I'm waiting, and the match sucks, and sucks, and sucks, and sucks, and I'm thinking, where are you? It's been months! We can't take another minute! Hit this ring right now! And finally, there to end this match and save the day, more important than kicking off the invasion, ending this match, Lance T. Storm hits the ring.
P!
Super kicks Perry Saturn. It's in Calgary. He's the only guy the place went crazy for here. The place is going just nuts.
Oh my God, they're going batshit crazy.
He super kicks Perry. He runs away. Blackman gets the pin. Place is just screaming and cheering. Great moment. Boy, it was a struggle getting there.
Well, it was amazing to watch because knowing where this all goes, it's even more astounding because, fuck, this was the first shot and it was so hot. Mm-hmm. This place just goes crazy. And granted, it's in Canada, but here's the thing. It doesn't fucking matter. When you're watching on television, all you see is the WCW guys show up and the place explodes with excitement. And there's a big opening shot in this war and he runs off. And of course, later Vince is mad and Shane's all happy and Lance is all celebrating. Man, they were off to a hot start. And it's all downhill, literally from here, because the Stalker shows up later. Like, this was right. The beginning and the end of the invasion.
This was the peak.
And I might add, in a beautiful tribute to World Championship Wrestling, the very first thing they do afterwards is Kevin Dunn shows a different angle where Lance misses the kick by 5 feet. I fucking died. I'm like, bro, you got one job. Just like Vinny every week when I say, what do we got next week? You got one job. Make this fucking show look good. And they have at least three angles, because we saw three angles of it. And you had to air the one angle where Lance misses the kick. I mean, fuck, come on. And he's still working there in 2020.
Yeah.
They showed Perry on the mat to sell the super kick, and Perry was literally cross-eyed.
Well,
literally.
Yes. So after the break, Lance runs out the building, runs up some stairs. Who's waiting for him but Shane McMahon? And they celebrate, and there's some fans outside cheering, and they jump in their limo and they flee.
They go to Vince, and it's the exact word for word. It's fucking uncanny. Exactly what I saw last night on Raw with Adam Pearce yelling at the security guys that this person was in the building, and they better fucking make sure nobody else gets in or they're all fired. It was the exact same thing. Except he added that this was some crape from WCW. I love that word.
creep from WCW interfering in a WWF match.
It's not used enough.
You're Canadian, but you're working for me tonight. He says, if anyone else from WCW interferes, you'll all be fired. And they all leave, and I am fairly certain that one of these guys was Orlando Jordan.
Could have been. Maybe he was in his time machine.
Might have been.